This is how you get what you want, what you need. Top of the line for shorty, blooming Project C. Got the smart for the school, but love the street living. Excited is my fame, the vision. Napoleon claimed the name, played the part, maintained the heart, knew the game. Street raised to stay smart. Shorty made it all for me, crafted 16. Do the math, added in dog years. That was too well advanced for all his average peers, but had a team on some wild out teams committed to. Rolling up, holding you up, slowing you up. Had his mate mad up for a stripe, sizing you up. Adapt tactic for wild avenues and crews. Concealed Maddox for any tribe blaze on you. Young calling the shots, only previews for dudes in all spots. Spoke for the boys who pump short shot and red tops. Now come the intricate plot, always a rivalry. Comps thinking lava, they try to be steady on the come up. Eye wide for opportunity. Seven signs of sin, wrapped up to spell. Only time will tell. Who goes to heaven or hell? We beat the streets. Riding out, thugged out, bugged and blackout. Lethal and provoked to arouse, hear me out.
Raise up, ease up,
ease up.
Raise up, ease up. Warriors come out to play.
This is the place where worlds collide. Separate clapper from rapper and rappers from actors. In too deep, must consider the factor. If it's fame, let's think it over. Only few heads get the name of supernova. The rest be focused, always about the hustle. Looking for ways to get paid using their muscles. Some stay trouble. Will I go gold? Even hit lead? She got me fed. Should I look for a job to stop back in my head? Until this world turn cold. Nigga, I don't care about you or how you roll. Don't hate a man for flashing, stealing his cash he never had. So when he slips, his ass out, leave him holding his dick. Labels more dick, slip willy. Smack a nigga silly, play tricks with they money. Too hungry, fake that. Had to do a move I learned from Havab. Desperate for greenbacks, $1 million stick hats. The meaning of this, Brooklyn ain't smell sticky. We come at us, be heavy every time, ever ready. Cool, cooler, grit, gritty, shitty. Believe, no tricks up the sleeve. We bang straight at your headpiece. Not meaning no harm to make it bad for your health. Raise up, ease up, don't make it bad for yourself. Penalties are momentary. Memories of the laws who paid costs was handled by yours truly.
Raise up, ease up. Warriors come out to play.
Apparently extraordinary, don't compare minds to legendary. Crossing thin lines, quoting my lines is purely entertainment. My same shit, I'll blow your back out, frame it. The same shit, will leave you on the floor brainless. Talking to me, best be making sense. Talking at me, prepare for ducking. Only showering, cheering, you hollering. Traits laced up with talents. Clean hands, saying a violent. Fuck with, nothing to lose. Ready to bust, step with mine. Non-believer luck, ill choice. Your lost chance, better to dance with the devil in the darkness, the slow jams, the sick type, the real life I'm concerned. Play with life, you get burned. Lack imagination, ill thoughts, use discretion. Never holding out for my peeps, keeps protection. Only way shells on you, breeze through, knock down obstacle and clean phony asses off their pedestal. Believe.
Hour number two. Let's go, baby. Yes, sir. Hey, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. I like that. I think we might need to add that to the show open, man. Hey, bring it back again, Waterhead, one more time. I like that. We might have to add that to the show opening. Hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. Oh, boy. Fantastic, freaky, funny football Friday, man. I keep saying that today is the last day we're going to talk about this Super Bowl, man. And I really, really do intend to do that. I promise you. Because it... I can only imagine, like, hardcore real Falcons fans... what their life is like. My cousin called me, it was like 2 days ago, like Wednesday. His wife, I guess she's technically my cousin-in-law, her name is Tracy. They called me and Tracy was crying. She got on the phone, my cousin called me, he's like, hey, listen, Tracy want to talk to you, man. She got on the phone with me and she says, Dougie, that's what my family calls me. True story. Listen, if you ever hear anybody call me Dougie, you can bet 100% that they're my family or they grew up with me. And so she says, Dougie, I just want to tell you, and she was crying. She said, I just want to tell you, I just saw your video when you lost it in the studio and broke your damn microphone or whatever. He's like, I just want to say thank you because that's how I was feeling. And I couldn't express it as beautifully as you did. It was funny, everybody saying it's beautiful because I lost it. I lost my damn mind in this damn studio. But I got so many people that hit me up, man, and you can go and look at the little post on the video that I did, man, that we posted. And everybody just says the same thing, man, like that's their emotions. Like when I lost it, that was my emotions. Like after the game's over, you just sit back and it's like, how did that just happen? What just happened? What just happened? You know? And Atlanta fans, man, they just go through the gamut of history and, you know, all of the misses that the Falcons have had, man, all the opportunities, you know, the Super Bowl in 98 where they made it and then Eugene Robinson did that crazy stuff, man. Bobby Petrino leaving in the middle of the night. Michael Vick breaking his leg, you know, missing most of the season. Mike Vick fighting dogs. And you get in the Super Bowl and you're up 28-3 with a quarter and a half left, a little bit more than a quarter and a half left, and somehow, some way, you find a way to lose. Possum luck. You find a way to lose. You find a way to lose, man. Boy, like, listen, I'm trying my best to get over this, man. And listen again, in relative terms to real Falcons fans, from people that were born and raised in ATL, Metro ATL, from people that were born off Simpson Road or Bankhead or Decatur, Stone Mountain, College Park, East Pernt. in relative terms to those people, man, you know, I'm probably a whole lot better off. But to those people, Marietta, Smyrna, Jonesboro, you know, those people got to hurt, man. Really? Really? Bomani Jones is laughing his ass off at this whole thing. Bomani was laughing his ass off. I could tell when I did a little interview with a man that he wanted to laugh so hard, you know, because in his mind, he's like, I told y'all. They some freaking schlep rocks. How can one city have so much despair, death, and destruction? Oh, man. From Sensational, you sound like a real Falcon fan to me, Doug, with all this crying. I guess so, bruh. I guess so. I don't know. I think what it does, though, is it kind of it narrates, you know, because y'all know I'm not from here. I'm not from here. You know, I didn't grow up with a rooting interest for the Atlanta Falcons. You know, I want to see them do well. But y'all, I guess it just proves and shows the point that it's still hurting me. And I'm like five, you know, levels separated from a real, real diehard AT alien. And this still bothers me that somehow they found a way to lose that game. It's crazy, man. From Sandman, I was thinking, is this Super Bowl loss worse than the Bills losing three straight Super Bowls? Ooh, not three. Was it four? I think the Bills lost four straight Super Bowls. Was it four or three? Let me see quickly. You listen to the Doug Stewart Show. I'll answer in a second. Let me pull it up here real quick. I think the Bills went to four straight Super Bowls, sir, not three. And lost four in a row. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. The Bills, AFC Championships, yes, four in a row, not three. I think Sensational is a little bit younger than us. The Bills lost four Super Bowls in a row. Was this loss worse than the Bulls, I guess, you know, as a package, the four losses in the Super Bowl? From what I remember in the Bills in the Super Bowl, outside of the first one where they had the wide right, I think the next three, they weren't really competitive. I don't think they had, you know, a real shot in those games to lose, if my memory serves me correct. And I'm not exactly sure. That's been a long time. Y'all know I took a lot of hits to the head. I don't know, man. Let's just say they're equal, because it's got to be tough for you to year after year after year, and that's where pretty much Falcons fans are right now, is – you know, we're hoping for the impossible in relative terms. I got some numbers on that a little bit later, to making it back to another Super Bowl after you lose in the fashion that you did. It can't be any worse, you know. And I'm sure there's some Buffalo Bills fans maybe listening to this show right now that say, man, it really hurt to go back and get geared up. New year, new attitude, spring hopes eternal. And you find a way to make it back to the Super Bowl and you lose again. That's got to be tough, you know. But I can't imagine it being any worse than what Falcons fans are going through right now. From Clay, I'll be damn Davis, the Bills is still worse. They had four chances to win. I guess maybe. And maybe I'm just caught up in the emotion right now and it's so, you know, fresh in my mind of what happened last week. Yeah, it's got to be tough to lose four Super Bowls in a row. Like, I don't want anybody, my worst enemy, to go through what Falcons fans are going through right now. But I can only imagine losing four in a row. From Terry, Republicans won twice green. Doug, that was the most humiliating loss in Super Bowl history. You will never get over it, bruh. The Falcons had the whole free world on this side and lost them in one night. Laugh out loud. Yeah, we keep talking about how, you know, they had all of these people rooting against the Patriots, so they were rooting for the Falcons. They had an opportunity of a lifetime to create lifelong fans. Like, little kids all over in America were going to go and get Falcons gear the next day. Like, they were already asking their mom and daddy, can you get me some Falcons gear? They're real cool. I love Devontae Freeman. I love Julio Jones. I love Matt Ryan. Can I get a Julio Jones jersey? Can I get a Quintaris Lopez jersey, mama? Then they fucked it up.